Welcome everyone to the interactive session by Auro University. Welcome ma'am. It's a great pleasure to have you on board, and I suppose that you will give good information to all the students who require guidance for their career.
Sure.
To begin with, I would like to introduce Dr. Meghna Dangi. She is associate professor currently at Auro University. With around 2 decades of experience in academics and corporate sector, she is also a chartered accountant, accountant and a PhD in behavioral science. Her domain areas of teaching include finance and accounting. She has various publications in the field of behavioral science and presents research papers regularly at national and international conferences, including IIT and IIMs. She also consults and trains in the field of personal finance and financial planning. Presently, she is the program coordinator of the postgraduate graduate diploma in financial markets, where she is instrumental in enabling learners in developing skill sets required to succeed in the financial market. Through career development, curriculum development, then industry integrated sessions, and as a co-winner of national level seminars into the field of financial markets. Again, I welcome you, ma'am, and over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Garima. Thank you very much for the kind introduction, and it is really a pleasure for me to be here on this platform. And as you know, our participants keep joining in, I guess it would be, I hope it will be a great session for all of us to discuss and deliberate. So as Garima mentioned, this is an interactive session. So I would love to have a lot of questions on, particularly on careers. So this session is basically for students, but you know, we are all stakeholders in the progress of students. Students are said to be the future of the country. So we are highly invested in the progress of the students, in the success of the students. So if there are any students or parents or teachers, trainers, counselors who are here and who want to interact as far as what are the various career options, what is the scope, what are the opportunities, then I would definitely like to welcome questions over here. And you can keep putting in your question in the chat box without any problem. I have my very dear colleague Garima who's going to help me moderate this thing, and whenever any relevant question needs to be asked, I give her all the authority to please ask me the question there. We also have the provision of unmuting you in case you would like to directly contact me over here. So we can do that also. In fact, we can include, we can have the conversation on this platform. So before I begin, I would like to just mention that here we are going to discuss careers for millennials, right? So when we say millennials, it is the students who are going to be going in the job market maybe 5 years down the line, 10 years down the line. So so when we talk of careers, then there are a lot of careers which are traditional, which have been traditionally taken up by the students, like engineering or medicine, or for that matter chartered accountancy, you know, like us who were 2 decades, who are, as Garima mentioned, 2 decades old. But then here we are talking about some new age careers. So quickly, I would like to share a very small presentation with you that what exactly are these careers and how these careers are going to be mainstream in the future. So other than these things, I would also like to discuss about what are the things which a student should look out for when he or she chooses that in which university he should take admission, right? And not only that, I would also like to discuss that what are the skill sets which are expected in a student to be there when he enrolls for a particular program. So there are some skill sets which are highly technical in nature, whereas there are some skill sets which are common. And I would also want to discuss that it is not only the curricular profile but also the co-curricular profile which a student has to now develop. That's very important. And how the student can develop that particular co-curricular profile so that he or she can get into a university or a college of her choice. So, well, let's start. So the first thing that I would like to show is basically this is the situation of the student mind right now. So, a student who has appeared for the class 12th examination, awaiting the results, and unfortunately, because of this COVID-19, because of the lockdown, things are pretty uncertain now. But then, as the lockdown is being removed gradually, we are trying to get back slowly and sluggishly into our normal mode. But I'm sure this is the situation in every student's and the child's parents' mind. So what am I really going to do? Can I really get there? What are the risks in that? Am I sure of the route? Where? When? What are the subjects which are most appropriate? And if I don't make it, then do I have any other options? So these are the very commonly asked questions, when a student is in class 12 and he is just at the threshold of making that decision, that so-called very crucial decision of which option to choose, right? So basically, when we speak of career, a career is not a one-time thing. It is not something that you choose. It is not a straight path. It is basically something which you have to do over and over and over again throughout your life. It's basically a journey, and rather a journey and not basically a destination. So before we take up what are the options that are there for you, I would just like to, make the ground for when we say career, then career is a very, very, it's a very big thing. All right. So first step is to know yourself. What are your interests, values, skill sets? What are your assets? What are your resources? What is your personality? Are you extroverted or are you introverted? Right. So what is it that you feel comfortable with? Do you feel comfortable with people, or do you feel comfortable behind the screens? Do you feel, do you have the passion to create something new every day? Or, you are more comfortable settling down in a well-structured theme, all right? So this is the first aspect, that to know yourself. The second one would be to explore the possibilities, that what are the options which are available. So research, try to know things, narrow down your choices and find out that what could be the best choice or what could be the best fit at that point of time. The third one would be to make those choices, right? So goal setting is very, very important here. We have to set our goals, we have to develop a plan, and we have to address whatever barriers are there. Finally, to make it happen. So actually putting the plan into action, learning along the way and achieving those goals. So basically, this is a journey which I guess every student has to undertake. And it is not only you have done this thing when you were in the 10th standard, you do it when you were in the 12th standard, you do it once you complete your graduation, you do it again once you complete your post-graduation, and things keep on moving. But then the thing is, it is definitely very crucial at the point when you are in the 12th standard, right? Because in a way, yes, it is a very important choice that you have to make. So although it is cyclical, but then yes, at class 12, the crucialness of this whole thing is a little bit too much. And hence what you require is to talk to a lot of people, take a lot of guidance from people, introspect and think that what is it that you are most comfortable with. And definitely, if you get an opportunity to interact with some people who have got some experience in this field, you should definitely not miss that chance. And hence, I would like to thank and I would like to you know, invite all those who have joined in this session as participants. So what are the factors that actually go into choosing your career? So as I mentioned, what are your skill sets? Are you a great communicator? Are you good with teamwork? Can you organize properly? These are your skill sets. It also depends upon your interests, whether you are the creative kind, you are the social kind, you are the outdoor kind, or you are an analytical and scientific kind. What are the values and motivations in life that you possess? Is it security, contentment? Is it money? Is it work-life balance? Or is it, you know, get that drive by helping others? What is your personality? Are you calm, outgoing, cautious, or determined? What are your contacts? What is your network? What are your qualifications? What is your location? All these are very important considerations or factors which go on to choosing a career. So basically, what I'm trying to do is to explain to you that here you are working in a constraint of choices, in a choice constraint. There may be a plethora of choices, but somewhere you have to make a framework for yourself that this is the framework which suits me, because this will really help you in planning. As far as choices are concerned, well, the choices are immense. And I was just reading a report. It was a FICCI report, FICCI as in Federation of Indian Industries. And it was prepared by EY, that is Ernst & Young. And the report was on Education 4.0. So what is basically Education 4.0, or what is it, you know, what is the central theme of Education 4.0? That is the student-centeredness. So one of the key themes of Education 4.0 is student-centeredness or student-centricity. How is it different from Education 3.0? Well, Education 3.0 was all about making teaching more effective, teaching more interesting by using technology. So now we are in a state of Education 4.0 where it is the student who decides how he or she learns, what he or she learns, from where he or she learns, and how he or she wants to be assessed. So we are completely, this is a complete paradigm shift where we are completely moving on to the student centricity. And of course, that is one thing which is taken care of very, very carefully by our university also, and I would mention that later. Coming to the different career options which millennials look for. So as I mentioned to you in this session, these are the areas or various options that we are going to talk about. So the first and the foremost option or career choice which the millennial students make is that of business and management, right? So, you know, when we say business and management, then basically what is the skill set we are looking at? So we are looking at a skill set which is, you know, you have a numerical aptitude, you want to work in the corporate sector, or you want to take up your family managed business to the next level. You are interested in basically managing the things. So what is managing the things? It basically means setting goals for an organization, finding out what are the various resources to achieve those goals, and finally making sure that there is a proper control, coordination, staffing, directing, which is going on in order to reach those goals. So that is basically what is management. As when we talk of careers in management, so basically these careers at the undergraduate level may be the bachelor's in business administration, which is known as the BBA. At some universities and colleges, it is also given the nomenclature of BMS, that is Bachelor of Management Sciences, or any such similar nomenclature. But basically, all the courses in business and management teach you subjects like accounting, financial management, marketing management, human resource management, decision sciences, etc. And of course, there are some courses which come with specializations also. So these specializations could be, traditionally they could be marketing, finance, and HR. But nowadays a lot of new specializations have come up. For example, taxation or international business, financial markets. We also have something what we call as BFSI, that is banking, insurance, and financial services. So basically, a course at the undergraduate level in business and management equips you with the basic knowledge of how business is managed. Okay, so all those conceptual things you will be learning over here. Closely linked with business and management is also commerce. So at the undergraduate level, one of the courses which a lot of students go for is the conventional BCom program. Okay. However, BCom has also rediscovered itself in the millennial age, and there are a lot of certifications which you can do along with BCom. It can be the USCMA, etc. In the field of commerce, of course, conventionally students are also going for career options, or you can say choices like the CACMACS, that is the Chartered Accountant, Cost and Management Accountant, Company Secretary. These are the various career options which the students are choosing from. Typically, these courses are 3 years, 3 year courses as far as India is concerned. In countries abroad, specifically in the US, all these courses are 4 year courses. They equip you, they give you that eligibility to pursue your post graduation after your graduation. Although if you are wanting to pursue from foreign universities, then you might be requiring 16 years of education. That is, after 3 years of an undergraduate, you might be required to do a fourth year, means either you can do a diploma course, so it could be a PG diploma, a postgraduate diploma. So you can do postgraduate diploma in family managed business, or you can do a postgraduate diploma in financial markets. These are typically the choices which are taken by students for pursuing careers further in business and management. Quite a few times students ask that, is it necessary to do a post-graduation? Is an undergraduate not enough for securing a job in the corporate sector? Well, to get into the corporate sector, there is no eligibility as far as you should be an undergraduate, or you should be a post-graduate, except of course quite a few. A few career options, maybe, like for example, if you want to get into academics, then definitely it is not only an undergraduate and a post-graduation, you must have possess a PhD also. Then there are, for example, you want to work in a bank, then the bank might be requiring some competitive exams for you to crack. So just an undergraduate might not be enough. Definitely, you can join any business or any corporate with an undergraduate degree, but it always is a good idea to go for a post graduation also, because at a post graduation level you develop those skill sets which will take you from a technical level job to a managerial level job, because the kind of matured learning outcomes which are designed for a post graduate program, they are definitely very useful in picking up those jobs over there. So we have talked about three careers as of now, three career choices, that is of a BBA, a BMS, and a BCom at the undergraduate level, with of course a postgraduate diploma in financial markets or a family managed business or something of that kind. And of course, at the postgraduate level, we are talking about the MBA. Next career option which students generally take up, or which is a very a preferred choice with students, is that of information technology. So you all know that we are living in the IT times. I mean, IT is something which is being embedded into each and every aspect of our life. Okay, so now we are in the time of the lockdown, and one of the very important things which is most talked about as far as our as far as our life is concerned is the internet. Okay, so this platform also, the video conferencing and other things which are becoming mainstream now are basically equipped or empowered because of information technology. So definitely it is, information technology is definitely something which is driving a lot of things. And in information technology also there are various things, for example, artificial intelligence, data analytics, bionics, neural networks, fuzzy logic, etc. In case you are interested in those fields, then information technology is the choice for you. So at an undergraduate level in information technology, we have courses like the BSc IT. Now, in quite a few universities, specifically in Oro University, we offer the information technology as a four-year program also. We have an integrated program also of 5 years, which is a BSc, MSc, IT. At other places, there can be a Bachelor of Computer Applications or some such similar course. Another course which is very much in vogue, of course, during this time because of the COVID-19, it has taken somewhat of a hit. That is hospitality management. So hospitality management is generally a four-year course wherein it is highly industry-centered, as in you have internships which are embedded into that particular program for a long stretch of time, maybe 6 months or a year. So a BSc in hospitality management helps you in securing jobs in hotels, in travel and tourism, in cruise, in airlines, etc. So this is another very, very interesting course. Well, at Oro University also, we are running this course, and we have a state-of-art infrastructure as far as hospitality management is concerned. And we have a special attribute to this course, as in we have a one-year internship during the third year of this particular course, where the students are going abroad, that is to the US or to Europe. However, in this particular year, this was a little bit of a challenge, but we were able to manage it for our students. The next career stream that is a choice for the millennials is law. Law is another stream which is really, really taken up, constantly changing, and lot of career opportunities being offered as far as this field is concerned. So law programs are generally 5-year programs if you want to pursue it after the 12th standard. So there are some exams which are to be written by the students in order to clear the eligibility norm, that is the CLAT and the LSAT. However, in case you have missed out on writing that particular exam, then the university also offers its own entrance test which you can write, and then you can enroll in that particular field. The next program, which is again very, very interesting, specifically if you are of the creative kind, and that is the program in design. So this particular program offers you various choices. You could specialize in communication design, in jewelry design, in fashion design, or in probably interspace design. So this is basically completely changes the way in which you think, because design is there in everything. All right, so generally again this is a 4-year course, and if you pursue it after the 12th standard, then after 4 years you get the degree of B design, And of course, you can either pursue a master's or, you know, you are very well equipped to join the industry once you have done the undergraduate. Another very interesting program and a very much a choice of the millennials is the program in liberal arts and human sciences, right? So basically, what is liberal arts? It is in a way very difficult to define, but in this, at the same time, it's very easy to define. So liberal arts comes from the words liberal, and liberal comes from the Latin word libre, means to be free. Okay, so liberal arts is basically the stream. It is said that anybody who is of the free mind, whatever he or she would like to learn, that is basically what is liberal arts. So here in liberal arts, there are various papers which you study. The various papers that you study could be psychology, could be history, geography, political science, English literature, etc. So this is a course for the millennials, and it offers a lot of flexibility as far as, you know, learning two disciplines is concerned. So if you want to study music and you still want to pursue mainstream psychology, so this is a program, you know, which offers you those choices, right? So that is the liberal arts program for you. And finally, the stream which is really catching up owing to which is really catching up, that is of pure sciences. Well, universities offer courses in pure sciences in specific fields like botany, zoology, chemistry, physics, mathematics, etc. So these are offered as honors programs normally, because you study a basic conceptual level, and what you finally go forward and do, that becomes your honors subject. So this is the pure sciences program for you. Well, I would like to mention that there are a plethora of career options that you might be having, and there are a lot of choices which you could take up. Owing to the time that we have, owing to the owing to various other factors, right now I am choosing about these 7 choices. There are a plethora of opportunities which are there for a 12th standard students. And we also have to remember that after doing these courses, you might decide to carve out a career in any particular specialization. So for example, the student who has studied management can definitely, work in a hotel and be a very successful manager, or the top level leadership in the hotel industry, right? So this is how it happens. Now we'll go forward and see that basically what do you require to enter in most of these careers. Okay, so other than, of course, having a great academic profile, there are various other skill sets which you might require for the purpose of being successful. For the purpose of being successful in as far as your career is concerned, so the first one is the general mental ability, right? So, if you are thinking that, well, you had studied maths till the 10th standards, and maybe after maths, if you have taken any of these courses, you will not need to study maths. Well, the answer is not really yes and not really no, because that level of maths, it will be required for you to crack any kind of, entrance tests for entering into various universities. So first is a general mental ability.
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt. We have few questions from the audience. So you would like to answer it now, or maybe after the session?
Okay. Yes, we do have a question. So, you know, thanks for the break. Let me take up those questions. So, yes, one of the questions that is being asked is what to do for going ahead in a journalism career. Well, thank you for mentioning that. And yes, this is also one of the career choices which the students are taking up, that is of journalism and mass communication. Well, very interesting career, because this career is seeing a lot of changes. We are definitely going from the print media to the digital media. And nowadays, we are all hooked to social media. Well, that's just one of the aspects. This career has got a lot of options, in the future. And what is required to for going ahead with a journalism career is basically having very good communication skills and having a skill set wherein you would you would be able to communicate not only to a person but to the entire community, to masses at large. As is mentioned, mass communication, that is why it is called mass communication. Okay, so these are the skill sets. Definitely, this is also one of the careers which we are which are preferred by the millennials nowadays. Well, the next question that we have is from a very dear student, Deep Raita. He is pursuing his BBA and he is currently in his third year, and he had taken marketing as a specialization, and he wants to decide whether he should do, in which field he should do his master's, and he wants to do his master's in Japan, and he would be immensely interested in learning the Japanese language too. I would like to know some future career scopes in Japan. Well, Deep, coming from a management background, I would like to say that yes, Japan is a very nice country if you get the possibility of settling down over there. As far as the future career scope in Japan is concerned for a graduate student, I think it would be a very good idea to pursue first a postgraduate over there and then only, you know, go and seek a job in Japan. But please keep in mind that Japan is an economy which is, so-called an aging economy. So the economic situation as far as Japan is concerned might not be very great, and as far as scope for settling down there or taking up a job over there might be a little challenging. So please take that into consideration. Well, Japan has got some very good universities. For example, the NTU, the Nanyang Technological University, is there. Nagoya University is there. Nagoya and Nanyang both offer courses which are aligned to marketing. In fact, NTU's program as far as entrepreneurship is concerned is very well known worldwide. It has got worldwide acceptance. So maybe you could look for a PG over there first, and then maybe you could look for a job over there. He also goes ahead to ask that, is there any scope of translation or interpreting job if I excel in Japanese language? Can this be a plan B? Definitely, this could be, I would not say it could be a plan B, but definitely it could be one of the side jobs which you are opting for along with your mainstream degree course, the PG course, or maybe another job. All right. As far as translation or interpreting is concerned, these translation and interpreting are possible to secure as far as India also is concerned, and definitely you could explore possibilities of a translation or an interpreting job as far as India also is concerned. So this would be my two cents of advice to the questions that I have here, and going forward with the presentation that we have. So I was actually mentioning that what are the skill sets, which you would require in any of these careers, whether it is business, whether it is law, whether it is design, whether it is journalism and mass communication, hospitality management, or design and information technology as a matter of fact. So the first one is the general mental ability. The next one is analytical reasoning, right? So, you know, just knowing your concepts is not enough. Just rote learning is not enough. What you need to do is actually build upon it. Okay, so how do you analyze? How do you, how do you critique a particular a problem or a particular concept which is given to you, right? And then how do you conceptualize and how do you synthesize? So these are some of the skill sets which would be required as you pursue your undergraduation. Next is technical aptitude. Now this is very important considering the situation that now we are living in, right? So if you recall, I had mentioned to you that we are in an age of education 4.0. So their student centricity is given a lot of emphasis, but then in order to be at the center of this whole ecosystem of education, what the student has to do is he or she has to be very, very self-initiated. So, you know, you must be very, very well aware, as well as you must be very, very comfortable with your technical skills. So, you know, it is kind of given that you are knowing the basic MS Word, MS Excel, MS PowerPoint. Also, you are very well conversant with using mobile apps, etc. You are having certain bent of understanding how AI or artificial intelligence works, and you have taken up some MOOCs, which are basically massive online open courses which are offered so that you can take some extra credits. They are offered by various organizations, and I would like to mention that even Oro University has joined hands with Coursera, and we are also offering courses from the various universities and professors worldwide. The best of universities, Ivy League university courses, are being offered to Oro University students through the Coursera platform because of this unique tie-up that we have. Next is your communication skills. So this is another very important skill set which a millennial student should look forward to. When I say communication, it means not only speaking skills, it means your reading skills, your writing skills. These are also to be taken care of very, very carefully, as in how you write, how you express yourself, what is the, what is your profile which you have on various social media, whether it is Facebook, Instagram, or even LinkedIn, because that is a professional profile which you are building up. It is like it is your face to the world at large. So communication skills are very, very important. They have become more important right now than ever. So you have to be an excellent communicator, that is given. Next is your general knowledge. It is expected of students who are doing their graduation to have a very good level of general knowledge. It is not only recommended to be very, conversant, which is going on, of what is going on around the world, but also have an opinion about it, right? It is not only important to have information, but what is your opinion? What is your thought? What is your perspective? What is the force with which you are coming when you are participating in a discussion? Then only you can make your presence felt. So general knowledge is again very important to have. And last but not the least, general awareness. Are you aware generally of what is going on in the country, in your region, in the whole world? So this is another very important skill set which the students are expected to have. The next part of my discussion will actually talk about how do you choose a university or a college. So when it comes for building up a career, as we discussed a while back, one of the stepping stones of building a career is to have the right degree. So once you have decided that this is the degree which I want to pursue. It's a management degree, it's a law degree, it's an IT degree, it's a journalism and a mass communication degree. Then how do I choose my university or college, in which university? So basically, I was just mentioning that, you know, what are the factors which you should choose, which you should look at before you choose a university or a college. So I was talking about the curriculum. So of course, curriculum is very, very important to look at. That is, I would place a lot of emphasis on curriculum. So is the curriculum updated? Are you having any choice-based options? I mean, is there a CBCS, that is a choice-based credit scheme, which is available in the university, so that you know you can choose that what you want to study and how, when you want to study that. So does a university have a choice-based possibility? Next is, what is the rigor on content? It is very important that when you are doing a course, whether it is at undergraduate level or it is at postgraduate level, the rigor on content should be immense, right? So, you know, you should be having a very, very competitive environment for that purpose. And of course, environment also I place as a very important option over here. And finally, is the learning blended? So nowadays, blended learning is very much in vogue. That is, there are some courses which you do at the university where you are residing, and there are some courses which you can take up of other universities, right? So, you know, are there any MOOCs which are being offered by the university or not? So those are the things which you should look at when you are making a choice of your university or college. The next important factor is, of course, faculty. The faculty, it matters a lot that who are the faculty, what is the faculty profile, you know. So you should go through faculty profiles before you are actually, you know, making a choice of your university or college. Have the faculty been involved in research? Have the faculty been involved in, you know, having patents which are registered to their names, etc. So a good faculty will always ensure a good institution. Next is infrastructure. Yes, infrastructure is a very important factor which has to be taken into consideration before you make the choice of the university or the college where you want to study. So infrastructure over here, I mean, not only about a comfortable infrastructure or air-conditioned classrooms, but are there, you know, systems, computer labs, labs if you're studying a course in design, or a course in mass communication, or for that matter, if you're studying a business or a management course, is there a business lab? Is there a communications lab? Okay, so all that infrastructure you should look at, because this infrastructure is going to provide you that additional, value add, which you are going to get when you are going through that particular course. Next is environment. Right? What is, I mean, how does that place feel? I mean, if you have seen the video which was being shown in the beginning of, while we were waiting for this particular webinar to begin, I mean, Oro University boasts of a place right now in which sanitization is being given a very important place, right? So what is the environment? Is the environment safe? Is it gender sensitized? Is it gender sensitive? Is it sensitized for people with, multiple, I would say, capacities, capabilities, challenges, etc. So the environment is very important. Next is, of course, the pedagogy. So, you know, what is the pedagogy? So by pedagogy, I mean that, are you getting enough opportunities to try out things, to experiment things? Because it is said that learning by doing, that is the most important way in which you can actually learn. So, you know, is this experiential knowledge or experiential learning being imparted to you? So pedagogy is something which you have to look at. It is very difficult to find out, by just looking at the university website, that what is the pedagogy that is being followed. So what you can do is basically try to speak to the students who are studying in that particular university, get in touch with faculty members as to, know a little bit more about, how the students are learning, etc. And another important aspect of choosing a university could be career development support. So what is the career development support which is being offered at the university? Because, at a university, it is very important that, the right kind of internships are given to you and the right kind of support for placement is there. All right. So what are the internships which the students are getting into? Because these internships will actually, decide your future placement. So an internship is nothing but an experience which is mentored by a faculty as well as an industry expert of giving you an opportunity to work in a particular company. So, or in a particular field or in a particular area of your choice. Right? So career development support is definitely what you should look at. And finally, is the university giving you the opportunity to discover yourself? Right? There might have been a plethora of reasons why you have joined a particular university, why you have joined a particular college, or why you have joined a particular course. It is not as if that, you are going to be stuck with it. All right. So it in the course of pursuing that particular degree, you might find that there is something different, which is your real calling. So does the university give that option? Does that university give that opportunity to discover yourself? All right. What are your value sets? What are the things that you are in sync with? What is your real calling in life? All right. So that is another thing which you should look at. So basically here we are talking about the science of living. All right. So these are the various features which you should look at in a university or a college before you decide to study over there. I think we are coming towards the end of the session. I have around 5 minutes left with me. So I would just in very brief like to mention that what are the skills, which are a must for success. If you want to succeed in your career, what are the skills which you should possess? So the first and most important skill is to be creative, right? So it is not as if that it is only a design student or it is only an artist who needs to be creative. Everybody needs to be creative. A person who is studying finance, hardcore numbers, he or she also has to be very, very creative, because it is only when you are creative that your mind becomes fertile and you come up with good ideas. So the first thing is always be creative. The second thing is always be empathetic. By saying that you should be empathetic, I mean that there is a certain emotional intelligence along with in your intelligence quotient, that is your IQ. Your emotional quotient is also very important. That how do you, how do you deal with your fellow mates? Are you capable to work in a team? What is your influence on others? So these are some very important aspects, or these are very important points to be kept in mind if you want to succeed in your career. Next, as I already mentioned to you, that you have to be a very good communicator. So whether it is speaking, whether it is writing, whether it is reading, whether it is listening, okay, these are all parts of communication. Unfortunately, we might be possessing very good speaking skills, very good reading skills, writing skills, but we might not be having good listening skills. All right. So listening skills are equally important as your speaking skills as well as your writing skills. So this is the part of being a great communicator. And last but not the least, it is very, very important to be a lifelong learner. I was just listening to Professor Srikant Datar from the Harvard Business School. I think those who are, you know, pursuing, who are having this wish to pursue courses in business or management might be knowing about Srikant Datar. He has written a lot of books. And I was just listening to his interview, and he mentioned that one of the skill sets which are required by millennials is to be able to unlearn, learn, and relearn, right? So this world is changing very fast, my dear students. In fact, it is said that whatever knowledge we have, it gets doubled in 12 hours. Can you imagine? In every 12 hours, whatever knowledge is there, that is being doubled. Okay, so in this scenario where we don't know what is going to be the future of jobs, the kind of jobs that we have right now might not be there maybe 10 years down the line when you are actually seeking to make very successful careers. So what is required right now is to have that ability to gear up with that ability of being able to unlearn, learn as well as relearn, right? So that I would say is a very, very important quality which is expected for every millennial, and he should look out at in order to carve out a successful career. So that's all from my side as far as careers are concerned. In case I can't see any Q&A as far as the chat box or the Q&A section is concerned, so I would like to end by saying that whatever has been mentioned over here, all those things are being offered at Oro University. Oro University was established in the year 2011. It is registered under UGC, under Section 2F, and we are offering all these courses. Along with the courses, along with the things which I have already told you, in case you would like to know more about the offerings at the university, then you can visit the university website or you can get in touch with our counselors. The university is open and our counselors are more than ready to guide you, to advise you and to suggest you what are the various career choices, what are the various degree programs, what are the various courses that we offer at the university. There are a host of things which are offered at Oro in terms of the educational experiences, whether it is the degrees, whether it is the certificate courses, whether it is the diploma courses. Along with that, we also offer opportunities to be associated with a lot of clubs and societies. We have an innovation lab also at Oro University, wherein we are supporting the young entrepreneurs by giving funding to their ventures and as well as mentorship to their business ideas, and a host of possibilities which you can actually take. There is one participant, Bhautik Kanani. He has raised his hand. Bhautik, if you could just mention your question in the chat box. Can we allow Bhautik to chat?
Yeah, ma'am, it's open.
Okay. Yes, Bhautik, you are allowed to talk. Please unmute yourself, Bhautik. Bhautik, you will need to unmute in order to ask the question. Okay, I think we can get in touch with Bhautik later on.
Yeah, ma'am, we can get in touch with him later.
Sure. Yes, Karima, in case you would like to make an addition to whatever I talked about as far as careers for millennials is concerned, from the perspectives of the offerings at Oro University, then...
Ma'am, I think...
Then please do.
Just a second. Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving such great insight to all the participants regarding how to choose their career and what factors they need to consider while they choose university and what parameters they need to look into. So, that's a great insight from your end to all the attendees and all the participants who were there in this webinar. Just one more thing, that's one additional thing only, that they need to choose very wisely what career they need to be into in case if they are choosing any field. So, because they need to think twice before entering into any field. So, that would be only thing that I would like to mention here. And if they want some, more information regarding the university and any courses that we offer, we are available. We are at the campus with all the precautionary measures that is there and that is by the government. So we are doing all that and we are following all those things. So we are open from 9:30 to 5 we are here, so they can visit anytime and they can call us also before coming. And also in case they want to meet any faculty members or maybe if they want to discuss anything, we can, arrange a meeting and maybe a con call with the faculty members as well. So that would be from my end. And also, ma'am, I would like to mention one thing about the scholarship. So yes. We offer scholarship to all the students. Those who are scoring good percentage in their 12th standard. So that is one thing. And this scholarship is not only for the semester one. This is for throughout the program, throughout the 3 years or 4 years, which program they are choosing or maybe which course they are entering into. So we are offering a scholarship to all the students on the basis of their percentage they are scoring on 12th. And from the second semester as well, we are offering a scholarship to the students. So that would be based on the semester wise.
And I believe it is not only the merit-based scholarship. We are at Oro University are offering need-based scholarship also.
Yes, so ma'am, we do offer that as well.
So in case the student is meritorious but because of any economic challenge is not able to pay the fee, we offer need-based scholarship also. Thank you for giving this opportunity to discuss about career options available after the 12th standard. Actually, as far as deliberating and interacting about careers is concerned, it's an ocean. Nowadays there are so many opportunities which are available for children, which are available for the millennials, that it is very difficult to wrap it up in an hour or so. But definitely, as a university, it is always our endeavor to reach out to students who want any information, any counseling at any point in time, as far as their studies is concerned and as far as their careers is concerned. So please feel free to reach out to us on at the university, and please keep getting our updates. Please keep following us on social media, that is Facebook, Instagram and LinkedIn as well. And we are doing a host of activities in order to gear up, in order to scale up the educational and the curricular opportunities, the curricular experiences to the whole community at large. Definitely the student as a stakeholder is at the center of our whole educational experience that we want to impart. But then faculty members, to parents, industry experts, as well as the community can reach out to us through our Facebook page, Instagram, as well as LinkedIn, and of course our website. The first line are definitely our admission counselors. So I think it is a great initiative on part of the admissions team to to have such sessions.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you so much, admissions team, specifically Garima, and hope to see you soon at the university.
Sure, ma'am.
Also start from.
Yeah, thank you.